was great timing for that to happen. Did you see that?
Yeah.
That was almost really bad. I needed someone up here to hold my strap for me that whole time. Talking about team building, I'm like, you can't even put a guitar strap on straight? What's going on with you? You know, I was talking about disruptions. Before I call, before I ever cry, you answer me from where the thunder hides. I cannot run this heart I'm tethered to. With every step I collide with you. Like a tidal wave crashing over me, rushing in to meet me here. Your love is fierce like a hurricane that I can't escape, tearing through the atmosphere. Your love is fierce. You cannot fail. The only thing I found is through it all, you never let me down. You don't hold back, relentless in pursuit. At every turn I come face to face with you. Like a tidal wave crashing over me, rushing in to meet me here. Your love is fierce like a hurricane that I can't escape, tearing through the atmosphere. Your love is fierce. You chase me down, seek me out. How could I be lost when you have called me found? Chase me down, seek me out. How could I be lost when you have called me found? You chase me down, seek me out. How could I be lost when you have called me found? Rushing in to meet me here. Your love is fierce like a hurricane that I can't escape, tearing through the atmosphere. Your love is fierce. 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 Your love is In Europe back in April, May, and I ended up playing that song at this college group. It was like a short notice, like 20 hours notice, because I had a day that I was trying to fill, and I ran across these people that drove 4 hours to my show the day before, and I'm like, where are you guys from? They told me, you guys can sit down real quick, that's fine, you can sit down. Story time, I don't want you to have to stand. And they drove 4 hours to come to this show that I played in this other city. And I'm like, well, where are you from? And they told me, I'm like, well, why don't I play there sometime? And they're like, okay, yeah, anytime. I'm like, how about tomorrow? And so it worked out. And I show up in this town, beautiful, beautiful town. And I end up playing that song at some point throughout the night. And this is all a bunch of college kids. And there ended up being like 60 of them showed up because they're like, yeah, okay, an American playing songs, I'll show up, right? And this is less than 20 hours notice. So I'm stoked out of my mind because I have a show and not a day off by myself in Europe. But also the fact that there are so many kids that ended up showing up because they're like, yeah, I'll come hang out. And I ended up playing that song, Fierce, right? That word, Fierce. It, to us, like, it's not a hard word. It's not a big deal. Anyway, I play it, and I end up like, your love is fierce, at the end or whatever. Like, I'm like, all right, cool, I'll do it that way. I'd never done it that way, but I'm like, all right, God, you're doing something, I'll do it. And at the end of this acoustic show, I'm in the back by the merch area, and this group of students come up, and they're like, they want to know what I was saying at the end of that song. I'm like, wait, which song? They're like, you're saying like your love is fierce, and then at the end you said something over and over again. I'm like, I said fierce. And they're like, oh, you said fierce. Like, whatever. I'm like, wait, what? I'd already said it in the song like 10 times or more, and then I just repeated it louder. And so it threw them for a loop. And so now every time I play that song, I think of that. I think of like, are they going to know what I'm saying right now or not? And so, did you guys understand that word?
Yes.
It's a pretty easy word. But I guess it's like them trying to say squirrel. They can't do it. They say squirrel, squirrel. I'm like, no, squirrel. They're like, squirrel. I'm like, you know what their word is for squirrel? Hang ching ching. Hang ching ching. Is it got like a weirdo? Hang ching ching. You didn't think you'd hear that this morning, did you? Me neither. I didn't think I would talk about it. But here I am. Hey, what song did I say was next? Is it Holy Spirit? All right. Okay. I didn't want to be rude and pull my phone out. But do you guys know the song Holy Spirit? One of you. Okay. Well, we're going to learn it now. We're just going to play it, okay? I love this song. I wish I had written it, but I didn't get to. But we'll see what happens. Cool? Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. There's nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're a living hope. Your presence, Lord. tasted it, seed of the sweetest of love. When my heart becomes free and my shame is undone, your presence, Lord,
Holy Spirit,
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. Be overcome by your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord.
Thank you very much. Because I'm so taken care of here with everything being set up perfectly, I didn't grab my capo out of my case, and so I was trying to make an exit, not be dramatic, grab my capo, come back, and be ready to go. But my capo was hung up on my guitar cable that was in my case by this little hook that's on this, and so it wasn't as smooth as I had hoped. And so that is a parallel of my life. Like, I wasn't quite as smooth and without issue as I hoped it would be. But how many things in your life that you think was the most difficult situation that you would never make it through, sitting here right now in these chairs, you look back, maybe it was a month ago, maybe it's today, maybe it was years ago, and you remember your 10-year-old self being like, oh, I thought I wasn't going to be able to make it through that, and here I am now. Maybe it's, you guys start school yet? So first, second week, probably? Third week, yeah. And you think the first day of school, how much you dreaded it? You're like, who's going to be in my class? And am I going to know anybody? Am I going to like my teachers? And here you are 3 weeks later, and you're like, psh, no big deal. Not stressing, right? Hopefully not stressing. I love how some head nods, some kind of like, some are like, some are like, please talk about something else. Sorry, you're stuck with it. I'm so glad to be here. I love it. I love it here. I love being able to be here. And I love it when I'm scrolling through my phone and I'm looking for a picture that I need to post on social media about, hey, I'm playing this show somewhere or whatever. And there's the one that was taken from over here, right here. And it's a group of people. It's black and white. You've probably seen me post it several times if you follow me on social media. It's because it's a great memory for me. It's great to be here. It's great to be able to come back. And so I'm very glad to be here. And this song is dedicated to, I'm going to say to all of you, because I know that we've all been in these situations, but maybe there's one of you specifically, this week's been kind of hard. It's been a hard week and you're like, I don't know what to do. I don't know who to talk to about it. I don't know if anybody will understand. But I know that there are people in this room that can listen and they can offer you advice that is not only good advice, but it's advice that is based upon Jesus. And it will give you hope. And so use today as something to be like, I want to leave this weekend. I'm going to leave this 30-hour famine in a better spot in my life, because I'm going to put some effort into finding someone to help me sort through this mess. So good to be here. This song is yours.
You must think I'm strong to give me what I'm going through. Forgive me if I'm wrong. This looks like more than I can do on my own. Strong enough to be everything that I'm supposed to be. I give up. I'm not strong enough. Hands of mercy, won't you cover me, Lord? Right now I'm asking you to be strong enough. Strong enough for the both of us. Well, maybe that's the point. To reach the point of giving up. When I'm finally at rock bottom, that's when I start looking up and reaching out. Strong enough to be everything that I'm supposed to be. I give up. I'm not strong enough. Hands of mercy, won't you cover me, Lord? Right now I'm asking you to be strong enough. Strong enough when I'm broken down to nothing, but I'm still holding on to the one thing. You are God and you are strong when I am weak, and I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And I don't have to be strong enough. And I know I'm not strong enough to be everything that I'm supposed to be. I give up. I'm not strong enough. Hands of mercy, won't you cover me, Lord? Right now I'm asking you to be strong enough. For the both of us, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength, and I don't have to be strong enough.
Sing it one more time. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And I don't have to be strong enough. Now I challenge you to sing it like you believe it. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And I don't have to be strong enough. You know what's cool? It's when you're good? Okay. I'm gonna tell you a quick story real quick, and then I'll be done. So what is mission? What's your mission? I'm not asking you to say it out loud, but what's your mission? What are you created for? What's something that is, it is your goal, like your main objectives, like I'm going to do this, right? And now flip it to where it's like something where it's like you don't only think of mission as something as like, my mission in life is to conquer the world and to be a whatever. Not that. But when it relates to Jesus, when it relates to Jesus and his presence in your life, when it relates to who are you, at the innermost part of your whole being, who are you? In your mind, who are you? Who do you think you are? And more so than that, who do you aspire to be, right? Maybe you thought of some sports person. Maybe you thought of some scientist. Maybe you thought of that. But who do you want to be? And you picture Jesus in whatever picture that you have seen 1,000 times in your life. I'm like, oh, that's Jesus. That's Jesus. That's Jesus. How are you going to get there? Right? I want to be that. Cool. How are you going to get there? And then you apply mission to it. Here's the thing. I'm a musician. I'm in a band. I get to do this. I get to play songs with an acoustic guitar, and most of the time I play them poorly and whatever, right? I get to do that. And I get to choose, what am I going to talk about between songs? What am I going to talk about throughout an acoustic set? How am I going to try to somehow encourage people? And here's the great thing. It's not only about encouraging the people that are in front of me, but it's like, God, what are you trying to say to me that you say to me and it ends up coming out of my mouth, but for me to apply to my life? I'm like, so often I'm up here talking, I don't know what I'm saying. I'm just being like, God, what are we doing? And I leave being like, oh, totally. That was for me. Like, that was something God used, song and story and whatever. And maybe it's something that someone said to me from the crowd. They're like, hey, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, holy cow, I've never even thought of that, right? Last night, I played at this bar in Little Rock, Arkansas. It was one of those short notice, like, I'm so glad I'm not off on a Friday night, right? I got to do something. I got to play songs. I had no clue what I was walking into, okay? You ever been that spot? You're like, I gotta go do this thing, but I don't know what to expect. Anybody ever have expectations in your life? How often are they actually met, right? You're like, oh, I got this. I'm so excited. It's probably going to be this. It's probably going to be this. This person's probably going to be this cool when I get to meet them. And you're like, wah, wah, wah. They were not cool at all, right? You understand that? So yesterday during the day, some friends of mine in a band from Little Rock who haven't played a show in like 2 years, but yet they're still connected with these promoters, they're able to get me added to this show last night at a place called Sticky's Rock and Roll Chicken Shack. Yes. Sounds made up. Right? Somebody made it up at some point. But it's actually this restaurant, downtown Little Rock. Great venue, great sound system. The sound guy, he calls himself Maestro. And it makes sense. He was an amazing sound person, right? I'm like, okay, you're really good. So here's the thing. Me walking into this whole situation, no expectation, because I've learned in my life to have no expectation, because who am I to dictate how something's going to go, right? I'm like, cool, I'm there. I'm going to do what I'm there to do, and hopefully it goes well, and I don't completely slaughter every song I play, but I'm in, right? Because it's not only based on the songs. It's the conversations that happen before, after. What kind of connection can you make with these people, right? That's a mission. That's somewhere where I'm like, God, I'm going to go into all the world as you want me to go, right? I luckily get to play all kinds of places, churches, bars, schools, whatever. So I'm there, and I believe, and I was speaking briefly a little bit about this to some of the leaders earlier, I believe it's important for you to be who you are at all times. When I say you, I'm talking me. It's important for me to be who I am at all times. Not only I'm one way when I'm on stage playing songs, talking to people in a show atmosphere, a church atmosphere, but who am I when I'm talking to my wife? Who am I when I'm talking to my children? Who am I when I'm talking to the guy at the gas station that I don't know, who that's his only impression of me ever in life, and I might never see him again, right? Am I kind? Am I stressed? Am I whatever? It's important to be who you are. Don't let anybody dictate who you are. Like, you're created specifically to be who you are. And that's like, all right, God, who am I? What am I doing? Where am I going? Let's go. So last night I played this Stickies, right? Let's just Stickies. And room of people that I'd never met, complete strangers. I knew one of them. Turns out I ended up knowing two of them, but one of them I hadn't seen in over 20 years, right? That's weird. Different town, different life, right? Anyway, I'm up there and I'm playing, and I did all these like cover tunes last night because I'm like, you're playing a bar. They don't know who you are, so you kind of want them to hear songs that they're familiar with so they can relate to it, or maybe it brings back great memories or whatever, and they're singing along and all this stuff. And so I played, I played 7 or 8 songs, and I was just talking, hanging out, you know, just making small talk, you know, people making comments. I'm like, oh, hey, yeah, crazy. I heard about the voodoo sauce here. Have you ever had it? Really, you've never had the voodoo sauce? That's crazy. That's the only thing I knew about this place until, you know, I got here tonight and blah, you know what I mean? You're like, you're just trying to meet them where they're at, and sometimes people are difficult, sometimes they're annoying, but don't take that too seriously, being like, okay, cool, whatever kind of day they're having, I'm not going to have their kind of day. I'm going to be who I am. I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do. So before the last song, right, last night, I'm up there, and I had a bottle of water, and I was just talking, whatever, and I'm like, hey, so anyway, I never thought I would be in this situation playing songs for anybody ever. Like, it's not what I thought I was going to do. I thought I was going to do something else in life. But here's the deal. And I talked about Jesus and the hope of Jesus. And I was like, everybody in this room, from whatever walk of life you're in, whoever you are, however you were raised, wherever you were raised, I believe that God created you for a purpose. And here's the thing. The God of the universe loves you. And he has a plan for your life, right? And so I just did that, and then I played the last song, right? And I walk outside, thinking nothing of it, because it's time to call, and it's even after my children's bedtime, but I'm like, I'm going to call, put them to bed, it's been a crazy day, all this stuff. And I walk out the back of this venue, and this is what I hear from someone, I don't know who it is or whatever, and they're like, testimony at a bar, huh? Wow, that's crazy. And I turn around, and it's one of the guys from the band that's the headliner that night. Like, they're the band. I got to open for them. I didn't know who they were, never heard of them until that day, right? And it took me a second because I'm like, well, yeah, that's my life. That's who I am. That's why I exist. That all those things kind of went through my mind. And then I'm like, oh, hey, what's going on? And it's two of them. It's two guys in this band. And they're like, I never thought I'd hear that at a bar. And to me, it's completely normal because spoken exists to tell people that, hey, Jesus loves you and has a plan for your life, wherever we're playing. To me, it's every day. It's like, this is what happens, right? I get to do this. This is crazy. But to them, to this group of guys who are on tour doing the same thing I'm doing, trying to build a fan base, trying to encourage people, trying to make a living, trying to whatever, that was so odd to them. And these guys were probably 30 years old. And they've never experienced that. And it made me think, I'm like, why is it that it's so odd? Because bands get up especially in a bar atmosphere, and they talk about whatever they want, and it's normally just awful, right? It's crude, it's rude, and they talk about whatever they want.
When I was your phone, still your love far from me. You have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all. You have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, never-stopping God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found. He's a 99. I couldn't hurt it. No shadow you'll light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow. Don't deserve it, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer chosen me. Love has called my name. I've been born again to your family. Your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer a slave. Thank you.
I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child.
So I have a few things I'd like to say, if that's okay.
Yes.
One, again, thank you for letting me be a part of this event. All day long, I've just kind of been watching, been listening, been trying to do what my wife would do. She would sit back, listen, watch while people are doing stuff. She would learn the character of every person in the room somehow, some way. I don't know how they do it or how she does it, but she does. I would watch the heart at work. I would watch one, I am shocked you got this to stand. And then the fact that you put one of the best things, Velveeta, across the top of it to bridge it, to make it to where it's like, it's all tied together now. And this is amazing that it's still standing. So I believe that is awesome. Another, to watch a basketball hoop being built. And if I could say, like, the fact that one goal that had been used a lot got destroyed, right? Storm, right? Blew it over, broke it? Is that what happened? Something that was being used, something that was being effective, something that brought in kids, something that brought enjoyment, was destroyed by a storm, okay? And then today I watched one being built before my eyes. I stayed away. I didn't want to interfere. I especially didn't want to mess it up. And then I got to play on that goal, right? I want you to look at the things in your life, the things that you hold so dear and so precious to you, and it's probably your phone, it's your computer, it's your video game system, it's whatever it is, right? It's a material possession, right? Much like that basketball goal that brought so much joy, laughter, frustration, probably on missed shots and annoyances, got destroyed in a storm. And you think of these things in our lives and you base it off of something emotional. These things that we go through, it's each of us, it's every person in this room. And we go through these situations in our life that we don't understand, and we become frustrated, or maybe we become bitter, or maybe we're heartbroken by whatever it is. We would call it a storm of life, this season of life that we feel like we're not gonna make it through, and we're just so distraught, right? Frustrated, sad. And then you look at once you make it through that storm of life, and you look back and you're like, that wasn't that big of a deal. Much like when that basketball goal got destroyed, it was probably time for a new one. And now there's a new one, and it's here, and it's gonna be here for years to come, right? Look at your life. And I want it to be communicated as a parallel of today. Sure, not 50 kids showed up today. Who cares? Big deal, right? 6 kids showed up here today to grow, to learn. You went out. You went out into the neighborhood. You did this. This is multiple meals for multiple families for multiple days. You did that. Why? You wanted to help people. How? You got out of your comfort zone. You knocked on some doors. You went out and about. You made an effort to do it. And it was part of this 30-hour famine. You sat and you watched videos. And I have to tell you, when that woman made it there to meet up with that family, and they're both in tears, and they're just hugging each other because it was from a distance for so long, and then it was real right there. That was rough. Like, that was awesome. And that's how I feel sometimes when I hear a certain song or I see a sunset while I'm by myself driving through the middle of nowhere. I feel like that's when God is speaking the loudest to me. And maybe today, you being here, maybe it is so awesome that the room wasn't packed with pure chaos all day. Because 6 of you came here, and I believe that it only takes God to speak to one person to change the world. To change the world. It only took God, one Billy Graham, to impact millions of people.
If you don't know who Billy Graham is, he's an evangelist who is no longer with us, but the guy probably every preacher who is currently preaching wanted to be Billy Graham. Every basketball player wants to be Steph Curry, LeBron James, Michael Jordan, of course, but they're going by who they have here. The God of the universe has a plan for your life. And maybe it's to do this right here. Maybe it is to go door to door and knock on doors and get food and take it to your local food bank and provide for the whole community forever. Maybe it's to go into missions. Maybe it's to go help families like the ones that you watch today. You know what? Maybe it's as simple as you having a relationship with Jesus and you going home to your family and you living out that life of obedience to Jesus, and your family's going to be like, what's different? A parent would be like, who are you? Why are you so kind right now? What's going on? God can change your heart. He can change your whole perspective of life. He can change the way you view every day when you wake up. And it only takes one of you being here today. It doesn't take 100 to get the point across for God to do something awesome. And so the fact that I look at everything based upon what I've experienced in my life and being on the road for 23 years and playing for 5 people, playing for 5,000 people. I'm going to do the same thing in front of however many people. I'm going to play and sing and put as much effort in to no matter how many it is. The same way here today. It doesn't matter how many people are in a room. Everyone else, I feel like they missed out on what you guys learned today. And, you know, you're going to bring it to them on Wednesday. That's cool. But you have multiple days up on them. And you have this experience today up on them. So let's just say you're going to make a bigger impact quicker. Straight up. That's all I'm going to say. But when those storms of life, when they come into your life, let this song be an encouragement. Let this song be something that maybe you can think of, or maybe you can go on YouTube and watch it, or maybe you've got 500 songs that you love listening to. But this song was based upon living in a situation that I didn't understand and brought me a lot of confusion. But looking back on it, it's like I trusted in Jesus, and you know what? He pulled through. And he did what he said he would do, and that's be there, to be in control, and to love. And that's what this song is.
Hard to believe so many years have passed. So many lessons learned and how some things never last. Holding on to dreams, waiting for tomorrow to come. So many bridges were burned from all the things we can outrun. All the pages in turn, and have I never learned? I guess some things never last. So wipe away the tears and never let me go. Be the hope when the world is crashing down. Come wrap your arms around me. Calm the storm inside me. Need to feel you standing close to me. Be the hope. Come back your arms around me on the stage. So wipe away the tears and never let me go. Be the hope in the always crashing down. Come back for long around me. Calm the storm inside me. Need to feel you standing close to me. Be the hope in the world is crashing down. Come back your arms around me. Calm the storm inside me.
Thank you, I appreciate it. You know, when things happen in your life at just the absolute wrong time, anyone ever experienced that? You're like, are you serious right now? I talk about it a lot, I know, but like Twilight Zone loves me. Like it loves me. I literally sitting there talking about this song. And the things in our life that sometimes distractions come and there's nothing we can do about it. Sometimes we allow distractions to just come in and wipe out everything in our life. It wipes out our plans. We make these plans that we are going to try so hard and to like follow through with these plans because everything seems like it's going to work out if we do it this way or do this first, this. Timing is perfect, right? And then the real world comes in and it's like all this stuff. I literally, that song moves quite a bit. It goes to spots that I have to make sure I hit those notes proper. Right before I started that song, I start getting a migraine. And so both eyes are blurry with these crazy lines through right here. And I cannot see the neck of my guitar. And I cannot see the dots on the top of my neck. And I'm just winging it. And I'm like, please be there. Okay, that was right. Please. Okay, that was okay. Luckily, this chord, I don't have to worry about seeing to. Was I stressing a bit? Yeah. Because I didn't want to hit a bunch of wrong chords on a song that someone asked me if I was going to play. And I'm like, yeah, I'll do that song. Isn't that how life works? Isn't that how it goes so often? Someone said that we make plans and God laughs. I'm like, oh, yeah, come on. I love you. You're so sweet, kid. Here's what's actually going to happen. The thing is, because we are human, it doesn't matter how old you are, there are certain lessons that are so important to apply to our life that we learn them day after day, day after day, day after day. And then we're like, seriously, what? I need to learn again? Yeah. It's going to be all right. Don't stress about the things that don't matter. Don't stress about the things you can do nothing about. Same way I couldn't control the fact that my eyes were blurry and I'm already having eye issues. You know what I mean? Like, I can't believe I get to do this. I can't believe I get to play music. For those of you who have no clue about my story before this, I never thought I would be playing music in front of anyone ever. I never thought I'd be playing a guitar. But God has a plan. And God's plans are probably different than what you think they are. And he has a way of making it happen. Because with him, it is all possible. If it's on our own, we're going to botch it up. We are going to botchy ball it up. But if it's up to God and we trust him, it's going to be okay. And this song is going to be one of those. Let's see what happens. Thank you again for letting me be here. I believe that each person in this room could single-handedly change this whole world. I believe it with all of my heart.
Working for the man to bring. he's holding him when he used to make it talk, 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 talk. Gina dreams of running away. She cries in the night time and whispers, baby, it's okay. If we gotta hold on to what we got, it doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We got each other, and that's a lot. Oh, oh, oh. We're giving a shot, sing it. Whoa, we're halfway there. Whoa, living on a prayer. Keep my head.
Thank you very much.